Hello, I'm Jeff Michael. Here's your CBS On The Go update. Thousands are going to be rallying in downtown L.A. today for May Day. The gathering will start at 11 a.m. right near Pershing Square. The march will end on East Temple Street at the federal courthouse. This year's event will focus on three themes: defending workers' rights, halting deportations that they say break up families, and urging people to vote in the upcoming midterm elections. Now, there's a big road closure. It begins today, and it is going to affect a lot of drivers who go back and forth between the San Fernando Valley and Beverly Hills, Century City. It's a water pipeline improvement project. Benedict Canyon will be closed between Mulholland Drive and Hutton Drive between 9 a.m. and 9 p.m. Monday through Friday, all the way until November. If you live in that area, you will be allowed in during those hours. All right, now here's a look at your weather with Daniel Gersh.
Hi, everyone. Happy Tuesday. So a front will continue to produce gusty winds, critical fire weather threats from the desert southwest to the south central plains and across portions of the Great Lakes. Severe thunderstorms ahead of that front could even bring damaging winds, large hail, and tornadoes as we head into today. High temperatures this afternoon, 60s from Salt Lake City to Denver to San Francisco, up into Portland and Seattle, near 80 in Phoenix, 80s from Dallas to Houston into Charlotte too, 70s in Manhattan. A nice day in the Northeast, highs in Boston in the mid-60s, 80s in Chicago. Dallas could see some weather-related travel delays. Other than that, you are in good shape if you have plans to travel on this Tuesday. Let's go through futurecast, because we are starting off May with some gray conditions and some on and off showers. Showers become scattered heading into this afternoon and into this evening. Snow levels will drop down to about 5,500 feet. Not going to rule out some thunderstorms as we head into this afternoon, tomorrow afternoon too. Scattered showers staying in your forecast into your Wednesday as well. Clearing out by Thursday though. Highs today below average and the 60s for many of you. So it'll be a cool day today. Another cool day on the way as we head into tomorrow. Then a big warm up in your extended forecast. Take a look. The sunshine's back on Thursday. We will see temperatures climbing into the 80s and 90s as we head into Friday and the weekend. So any plans you have for the weekend, you're in great shape. Just have to get through some showers today and tomorrow before we get there. Jeff.
All right. Thanks very much. Pain relief, rehabilitation, better skin, more energy, maybe even weight loss. CBS 2's Lisa Siegel checks out infrared light treatments and talks to an expert about whether or not they work.
This may look like a tanning bed at first, but when the lights go on, it's the complete opposite. Instead of damaging UV rays, these pods use infrared healing rays. Pilates instructor Maya Safran can't get enough.
For me and my injuries and joints and things and skin, I feel like my skin looks better. It's wonderful.
At Sauna Bar in Brentwood, clients go in for a 40-minute session. Healing jade crystals line the pod and are heated with infrared rays.
Could just push up.
If you're claustrophobic, nothing to worry about.
It's a cutting-edge technology that helps with healing, sweating out toxins, reducing pain, getting a nice glow.
Infrared light treatments are showing up everywhere, from at-home devices to wellness centers to doctor's offices. Used on people, even pets. Chiropractor Eric Nepanashi uses it for pain relief and faster recovery.
It takes about this natural healing response that makes it go faster.
He says look for FDA-approved devices and says study after study do show when the correct ones are used in the right hands, this therapy can help. He uses a more high-powered treatment but also believes the pods work and are safe.
They're using a significantly lower power output on the light, and that's still creating a tissue response, so people are seeing benefits.
At Sauna Bar, there's also the bonus of soothing heat all over your body, which makes you sweat. One session, they say,
you burn up to 600 calories,
along with reducing stress and anxiety. Myra Safran says once she came in, she was hooked, simply feeling better from the inside out.
It does work, and I will keep coming back.
I'm Lisa Siegel, CBS 2 News.
Now, here is your CBS On The Go Sports. Some heartbreaking news for Dodgers fans. Corey Seager is out for the rest of the season. The Dodgers put Seager on the DL yesterday. He has a UCL injury. That's his right elbow. He's going to have to undergo Tommy John surgery on Friday, which replaces the UCL with another tendon. That will keep Seager off the lineup until 2019. And that is your CBS On The Go update. I'm Jeff Michael. Remember, we're always on at CBSLA.com. And be sure to watch us on the CBS 2 News at 5, 6, and 11 p.m.
tonight at 11 in a three-month-long CBS 2 News investigation. Necessary surgical procedures for some veterans postponed or canceled.
I don't believe there's any hospital in this country that would find it acceptable.
A dark secret from the OR that one VA hospital doesn't want you to know.
They could transmit the bacteria?
Correct. They could also lay eggs on the open wounds.
David Goldstein exposes the VA's dirty secret and how it's been happening for years.
That's a tremendous problem.
Tonight at 11.